Last week, the budget committee expressed concerns that the Bank of Uganda could be involved in irregular lending to government, which can deplete national reserves. This after a revelation that government has an outstanding liability of 3 trillion shillings owed to the central bank. Appearing before the budget committee today, the deputy governor for Bank of Uganda, Michael Ating Ego, conceded.
For the redeemed securities was very constrained. Now, the government therefore requested to delay the repayments for security redemptions in order to meet these more pressing needs that had got to do with the health and the life and the livelihoods.
But the MPs insisted that the practice that saw money given to the government was unprecedented, arguing that the move amounts to lending.
So we want to know the level of maturities for which they have only committed, because when you look, they have only committed to pay 800 billion, thereabout. Eh? If you do 2.1 and minus 1.2, you come to 8.7.
And therefore, the way you are conducting business with means of finance, you are conducting it in a casual way. But if you use this institution of parliament, some of those pressures you get will reduce.
So to say that Bank of Uganda lent government, I think the word lent should be put in inverted commas. But it's not that it's okay, we're giving government money, but we're caught up in the situation.
The governor revealed that the bank signed a memorandum of understanding with government for the money to be paid back in two financial years. But to date, not any remittance has been made since 2020. He warned of consequences if government fails to pay.
But to date, the 1.25 has not been received yet. And all the maturities for financial year 2022/23 have not been paid in full.
By end of this year, 30th June, we expect 2.12 trillion to be paid. That would be to start covering the MOU of 1.25, and then there is the maturity for this year.
The 3 trillion shillings includes matured securities which have been paid by the bank on behalf of government. At least 1.25 trillion was to be returned by government for two financial years, but government has not fulfilled to date. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.